Hey Nick, by the way, I got to catch up on your notes on DM. I apologize. I've been challenged lately with the opening of the oil room. Man, every second of the day went into that to get it ready. It's ready now, but wow, did we ever push? We pushed. Knackety knack. I haven't pushed like that for a long, long time. Like, I bet you 10 years. I hardly slept. My bulldog hardly slept. Okay. Because he's funny. He'll only sleep when I sleep, right? He eats when I eat. He sits up and watches TV when I watch TV. When I'm on the computers, he's sitting here with me watching the stocks. He gets a lot of screen time. Okay, $1.69, testing the 200. Love the trend line. Can't get enough of that. It's just beautiful. Like, how could you lose on this? The only way you could lose on this is when it was so overextended. It was crazy. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, look at that. See, there it is. Wanna see it again? One, two, three, four. Five. Oh, there it is. Never go in here. After the sixth, go in. Because you're in for a double. But don't go in on the fifth. If you're not sure if it's five, be careful. A lot of people would argue this is actually six, but anyway, use your stops. Not that it can't get up higher than that later, but it's just not healthy for a stock not to come back and test. So where's it at now? It's healthy. It's testing the 200. Stock RSI is up. MACD's flat. Squeeze momentum's down a little bit. Same thing. Bulls are just holding on. Identical. So that's NAC. So the bulls are holding. LACDF we looked at. And TRCH, I'm still in, I think, TRCH, aren't I? I'm pretty sure I am. It's one of the smaller bags I'm holding. My bags are, well, some of them aren't the best quality. Day trades when they turn into. Yeah, TRCH. I'm still holding one, two, three, four, five of them. Yeah, the only one I'm not sure about is that SSH, but Legacy, Torchlight. I'm pretty well, ESEA, maybe not. I'm not sure. LIGA, I'm going to get out fine. TRCH. But you know what? For the amount of trading I do, that's decent, right? For a 6 month period. A few little bags here and there. How's oil do? Oh, see, that's the magic of an algorithm. Look at that. Machines are going home. They're taking price home. Those little red circles, that's home for them. They need to go visit. That's how that works. They're just programmed to do it. Isn't that interesting? So I sold too early down here, but I played safe. So I'll wait for oil to get up at its resistance up in here, and I'll short it until it comes down in here, and then I'll long it. I might intraday trade it too, right in the quadrants. It's getting up to resistance on a quadrant, so if you are long oil, you might want to trim a little. I'm not saying it'll stop there, but that's a resistance wall. I was training somebody the other day on it, and I said, yesterday, actually, I was training somebody yesterday, and I said, just picture a mouse running around, and these are little walls. I mean, kind of stupid, but if you picture them as walls, it helps. Like, say, like a pinball, it has to, it hit, like, that's a wall, it hits the wall and has to bounce over it. anyway, whatever helps you picture it. But you know, those are support and resistance, trust me, more so than anything else. Okay, we're gonna look at TRCH quick. Let's see what's shaking there. TRCH. Wow, crude's up 1.58% today. Didn't look that healthy this morning when I was trading it at 3 or 4 o'clock this morning. Gold is up. Wow, did our algorithm hit that? Perfect. Rosie the algo. We're going to start showing Rosie to the world here right away. Next week sometime. We've been hiding her for a while. Well, she's testing. She's testing high. Very high. Okay, TRCH. So, I've been in it for a while. And, you know, my buy is right around here. Maybe a little lower. I'm trying to remember. I'll have to look it up. But, could even be higher. I can't remember. But the point is that this is our setup. Now, you have to be cautious because it did come through the 200 before and it failed, right? So whenever you see that, you say, well, you know, that's not necessarily our setup because we want stocks that respect the 200. But it's not bad. The one cool thing is its symmetry is like near perfect. So you can almost, you know, like the next move, where's your trend line right here? Clone that baby. Yeah. The symmetry works. So when you get your next bounce, depends where it is. And it's not only that, but wonder if are those double helpings over there? So clone that. Go over here. So the symmetry is a little off there. So that's almost a perfect double helping there. Anyway, I'm just showing you real simple charting there, but I'm not really showing you anything of much value. But I do this, by the way, when I'm trading. Well, we use 53 indicators, so I'm not going to get into it all right now, but yeah, look at that. Anyway, it's decent. The bulls are holding. That's all you can say about it. When the MACD flattens out like that, it's testing the 200, and it doesn't hemorrhage, bulls are holding. It's up 7.64% today. There's no reason its next leg can't hit 213. And who knows, maybe you get a double. So that's TRCH. You know, one thing that you can do is you can always bring a stock into the room and say, hey Kurt, I'm in this one, I'm underwater and I want to know how to get out. I can help you with that too, by the way. I'm pretty good at that. I'm not very good at very much in life, but that I'm pretty good at. Trading out of stocks, out of bad positions, it's an art and you can do it. And the secret isn't to keep hammering down until it bounces. That's the way to blow up your account fast. Yes, oil's coming off a little bit there. Okay, where's the momentum? Scanners, where are you? Let's get a good one. It's 2:11. It's time. It's time for the moles. Where did the days of power hour go? Like, seriously, we used to get really good power hours on the markets. You know what my theory is? My theory is as the markets get extended, things like power hour in the afternoon become dull. Okay, I'm looking at the scanners here real quick. Pardon me, sorry. Patio doors, by the way, that's why you'll hear a bunch of cars and stuff. So AMD had a good day. Thing I don't like about, you know, like a lot of these guys, you know, so, you know, MGTI, I think we will see another leg higher very soon. Well, yeah, you think so, but the problem, it just bugs me. It's like, why think about it? Like, why guess? Why have yourself in a position where it's like, well, you know, maybe, maybe not. There's enough maybe, maybe not, even with the technicals when it's set up really well. That's just me. Debbie Downer. Donald Downer, sorry. BlackBerry seems to be consolidating nicely at current levels, really. Oh, I shouldn't be so down on these guys. So my scanners are quiet. Social media's quiet. Going on out there? The S&P is still red. Gold's up. Crude oil's up. S&P's red. Well, the S&P shouldn't be red. So what's going to happen is, in 15 minutes, crude oil is going to close. And then, I'll tell you what's going to happen. The S&P is going to get happy. What's VIX doing today? Mm-hmm. What's the VIX doing? It's up. No, that's not the VIX. Where did the VIX go? There it is. Dead. It's unbelievable. I don't think it's going to be dead much longer. But for all intents and purposes, it's dead. It'll squeeze out of this, though. Kapow. Soon. Soon. I think gold knows something. What's this headline? Stock slip as Wall Street braces for Comey. Oh, really? As if. What's the date on this? December. Is that what I'm seeing? December 6th. There you go, sometime before December 6th. Well, actually, we might as well take it right to where? December, call it December 10th. Okay, could be a while. Wow, incredible. Totally incredible. Unreal. You know what we probably could do? We could all look like we're really smart. You go from here to here. Oh, come on. What's wrong with the chart? And then clone it. See, you want to show the market how smart you are. Clone. Don't tell them how you did it though. See? Funny. There you go. It might not get serious action until December. Anyway, sorry, I'm off track. But pay attention to that. Try and remember that as we're getting into December. Buy some VIX. Okay, what am I doing? Momentums. Where's my momos? Right, I was getting ready for the S&P to go green. Allergies are bugging me again today. Okay, where is my S&P algorithm? I need to go to, what do I do? Oh yeah, go here, spy. Ooh. Spy. Only I've seen this. Literally. Well, the pumpers are working on AEZS right now. Telling the world how good the chart looks. Find a bottom play that'll pop. The shorts are done with it. So when the shorts cover, it'll pop and I look like a guru. Okay. I didn't say any of that. Delete it. Forget I said it. Missed that target. So it's divergent now. Overshot that target. So that's where it started to get funky. So why is it funky? Was nailing all the targets. This target down here is possible, and that target there is possible. These are the two possible targets. I know. This doesn't look like it makes a lot of sense, but trust me, those are the two targets. So, now this one's more probable than this one. It has to get through this diagonal line to the downside, and then that's the target. Until then, that's the target. So how much upside have I got here? Potential. I've got potential upside from here today to here. Potential, I'm not saying that will. There's a lot of clear blue sky in there. Okay, not real blue sky, but you got the point. Let's go over to... Oh, VIX didn't get off the mat, though. That makes this play tough. I'm going for XIV, right? But it's an inverse volatility. So, I mean, it's related to SPY, but it's not. it's related to, you know, the inverse of volatility. Now, it in itself is an algorithm. And try and figure out that algorithm. Oh, sorry guys, there's some questions here. Kurt, next quad up, setting up nicely for CL. Tracy, I have some of both. What do you got, Trace? Tracy, I hope with the nice examples and not with underwater stocks. Oh, sorry guys, I've been missing a lot here. I'm really bad at this. No worries. Good heavens, I could That's awesome. I love honest people. Okay. Well, let's look at VIX, or I mean XIV, really quick. So understand, these plays are algorithms, and I have investigated these algorithms in great detail because this is what I do, right? Math. XIV. So we want to know what XIV is up to. The VIX is dead, so that doesn't really help me. See, what you want is you want volatility to be really high when you do this, what I'm about to look at. And so it limits my upside on XIV, because you want the inverse of it, right? So when the S&P takes off after oil closes for the day, because everybody gets happy and nobody's panicked. Mind you, oil's up on the day. Yeah, it's not a really good setup, but I used to make a living off this one setup. It's a fantastic setup when it works. But the problem is the VIX is not way up right now. So how much upside is there? That's the question, right? Wow, what date have I got here? I haven't got into XIV for quite a while. Oh, come on. I don't know how to fast forward. Sartaj does. He does it all the time. Do I just hit this here? Yeehaw, look at that. Okay. So I got resistance right here at 80.94. I got resistance here at 79.57. I got a few other little resistance. I got a cloud to get through and a big one to get through at 80.94. And I got a bit of a gap to fill. 80.50, 80.64. But VIX is dead. That's the problem. Shoot. And the chart bot hit it here. Missed it here. Hit it here. Hit it there. Hit it there. So it's hitting the buys right, and it's hitting the sells right too. Well, some of the sells. Sure looks like a double bottom, doesn't it? Stock RSI is up. So the stock RSI is in the middle here now. This is a different setup, chart setup. True strength indicator is up, or flat. Awesome oscillator is about to go green, I think. So then the question is, on the S&P, are we going to get MOMO here? So this is the 5-minute algorithmic model, and what we want to do is blow this up really quick. It's too bad. Yeah, it's got resistance where this gray line is. It's got resistance where this diagonal gray line is. And oil's going to close in 4 minutes. So going back to oil really quick, Mr. Bernard. Just so you know, the gold algorithm, until those updates come out, Sartaj, we don't want to be, because we have been, well, you already know, we've been keeping that to ourselves, but it tested well. So I'll produce the new one tonight, maybe tomorrow at the latest. It's second best to Epic. It's easier to understand than Epic, though. S&P is the most difficult one to understand, the six. So anyway, oil's about to close. So if you're in oil right now, you might want to consider just on the intraday getting out. I should be careful, but well, I'm a little late on that. It hit the resistance up here, right? But it's got the target for 4:30, so who knows, it might get there, because it's saying, it has to go home there, right? Anyway, my point is that there's a few points. So when oil closes, the market kind of breathes a sigh of relief. The problem is that the VIX is trampled to death. XIV is an inverse product, an algorithm based on inverse volatility that is affected by lift in the S&P, indirectly. But is the S&P gonna get any lift? So the problem is, even if the S&P gets lift, XIV likely won't get much because volatility isn't high. That's the whole point. So if you ever have volatility really high and you know the S&P is going to get lift, one of your best plays for your buck is the XIV. Like example, Brexit. When Brexit came, if you see, you can always figure out if a guru is, worth his salt. And here, for those that don't know how to do it, what you do now, if they delete all their past tweets, well, it doesn't help you. I don't know. Is it cached on the internet? I doubt it. But you just go to the search bar and you type in at Kurt Melanopoly, and then you type a keyword like Brexit and see what Kurt was saying about Brexit. Well, you'll see that when Brexit happened and like people were like, "Wow, the sky is falling," Kurt was hammering down, leveraging houses to get XIV because volatility was spiking. And when that snapback came, oh my, like one of the best, one of the best. So anyway, when the election came, like you can check it out. Go at Kurt Melanopoly and type in things like Trump. Many months before, I was like, "Oh, Trump's like hands down. There's no question he's gonna win." But I could have done it at the election too. I didn't. I could have done it, but I was in Panama and we were setting up the office for compound trading, and I was enjoying myself at night. That was stupid, but oh, oil's got some jig here. It's gonna go after that target. Oh, look at that! Oh, that's bullish. Anyway, so I think you get the idea of that setup, right, with XIV. But today's not the best. But oil's gonna close here and less than a minute. So is the S&P going to get lift is the question. If the S&P gets lift, is there a little room with XIV? Sure, a little bit. Where's that S&P algorithm? There it is. So we'll see. Now, on some of these charts, you got to be careful with these lines, because that line is obviously off by, well, it's not off by far, because those tails aren't important. But the difference between 243.44 and 243, so it's off by 3 cents or so. But when you're doing a whole bunch of different time frames, like this one is very complicated, the S&P's algorithm's the most complicated of the bunch. To be off by 3 cents on your line. Oh, you can see where the line is off here. Anyway, 3 cents isn't going to make a difference. So I'm looking for the S&P to get up over this resistance here. Maybe get some lift. Do I really want to take that though? Coleman, Matt, guys, can you hear me, Sartash? Oh, good. That's great. Thanks, guys. Oh, see, here it comes. See, oil's closing. This is the setup right here, playing out live in front of you. But the problem is, VIX isn't very high. So you could use, I mean, you could trade the S&P itself. You could trade, you know, there's ETFs for the S&P direct. And you see, normally, like, if the VIX was escalated right now, the VIX would be, you know, getting trampled. It's already trampled before this started. So, you know, XIV would be up here by now. Anyway, it's a fantastic play when that setup happens, but, you know, VIX is dead. So, you know, I could have loaded, you know, just one of the ETFs right here for the S&P, but it's resistance, just so you know where the resistance line is. It's right here in the algorithm, and then it's here, and this is strong. The thicker the line, the stronger it is, right? But here, I'll back it off a little bit. So here's your targets. Now keep in mind, the last two targets, it's been hitting all its targets. The last two targets are divergent, so it's something's going on in the S&P. But you know, there's one target here, as long as it stays over this diagonal line. So this is the quadrant. The quadrants in the S&P algorithm are way different. They're not perfect diamonds by any stretch. But anyway, there's one target there. If it loses this diagonal line, there's another target down here. And you guys are the first on planet Earth to see this other than me. Well, of course, we have subscribers that have seen the S&P algorithm, but not this specific version. So anyway, it'll probably get lift, come up here, come down here, and hit this target, is my guess. Or completely suck out and hit this target here. So you can see it there, like the XIV is getting a little bit of lift, but not much. Nope. And it's not gonna. So oil's closing. Closed. And look at it, hit the resistance right there on the quadrant. Okay, momentum scanners, where are you? Let's make some money. It's 2:34. Anyway, I was saying earlier, I remember the day when we, you know, in the afternoon, we would get momos. But that wasn't very long ago. Get strong momos. We still get some here, but you know, nothing like we used to. Sorry, I'm just going through scans and posts and stuff here. Some of the stuff that people say on social media. I guess it's stuff that you just normally wouldn't say in person. Some people just don't know how to handle it. Look at that, going for the target. That's typical. It went for the first one earlier, got out of its time cycle, test, and boom. And you know, when it does that early, that's a tell, just so you know. And I should have never sold where I sold, like I sold here, right? I mean, I, you know, it was a decent trade, but the reason why I shouldn't have sold is that we knew, right, while it was trading in that quadrant. So I'll just go up here as soon as my chart cooperates. So refocusing here, you know, this in here, and you know, well, could call it here, but while it was in here trading, you know, in between its support and resistance, well, here I highlighted it, you know, the whole quadrant area, but this was the test line, obviously. When it got bullish before the target and it left the quadrant, that's a tell that it's so bullish. If it gets bearish before the target and leaves the quadrant, that's your tell for bearish. I mean, it sounds simple enough, but remembering that when it's happening and money's on the line is tough. I mean, I just made the error. Like, that I should have known. It left the quadrant to the north, bullish, before the target. That's always a tell. There's no reason I should have sold there. That wasn't the right sell point. So anyway, it got into this target up here to, you know, being bullish, not down into a target, but up into a target before the target. That's a tell. That's bullish. If it gets down into a target earlier, that's a bearish signal. It is a tell, just so you know. Because when it's not, like what you'll see it do is, like here, you might see it still hit both targets, but if it gets up into here and it's doing its thing up in here in a bullish way, and then right at that time it collapses into this one and then comes back up, that's not bearish. It's only bearish if it like works its way down into it, you know, early, and then loses it before the target, and then loses the quadrant. That's bearish. So it got into the target early from a bullish perspective, left the quadrant early, super bullish, and I shouldn't have made that mistake. But I'm learning how to trade the algorithm too, right? And trust it. I'm still learning how to trust it. Okay. And Sartaj has to code it. Yeah, the scans are pretty quiet here. Thirty-nine. We're getting into that time of day where it's got to happen. So did the S&P get lift? See, it's up over resistance. Just gotta wait for oil to close when the S&Ps are at. Bears will have all kinds of reasons for it on social media right now, but it's really simple. Oil closed. Yep, scanners are quiet, social media is quiet. Our setups are quiet because the alarms aren't going off. The triggers. The momos, there's not a lot different going on here except for this VTL. Is that what it is? Vital Therapeutics. I missed that one. Or did I look at that one earlier? No, I obviously missed it. Very interesting. So 338, 31% on news. Well, that's on close watch now. There's that pop and spy I was talking about. If you're long, be careful. There it is. See, XIV didn't get the pop. Inverse volatility, it just won't work. Hey Sartaj, if you're in the room, remember you were telling me about that back-tested moving average guy that built an algorithm on the MAs. What was his return? Was it 800% a year? 300% a year. Yeah, that sounds right. Yeah, 300% is doable. MAs. But he had kind of a weird exit program. Like it was a certain number of days or whatever. But I wonder why he didn't just do the MAs the other way on the exit. Like it doesn't make sense. Probably would have done better. Now I see the S&P is going now. It's giving her. Okay, so I'm gonna take the guru's bait. I gotta do it. AEZS. Let's take a look. I promise I won't go out on a rant. I won't say anything negative. I'll just take a look, because maybe there's a momentum here for us. Okay, so we got 294,000 shares at just over a dollar. So there was a whole $294,000 worth of liquidity in this stock today. Sorry, I'm snorting. Wouldn't do this. Okay, UAP. Let's run the daily. Take a look. Nice chart. Let's look at it a little closer. Let's call it the 60 minute. Beautiful chart. Let's get in it so it can drop. Let's get in it so it can drop. Let's get in it so it can drop. Look at it a little closer. Well, it's got this. I mean, the 200 did it did come down, and it got you know, prices above, and yeah, that did happen. MACD is flat. Squeeze momentum is flat. I mean, that's as dead as a MACD can get, just so you know. Doesn't get much deader than that. May as well have buried that MACD. Squeeze momentum doesn't get much deader than that. May as well have buried that. Stock RSI, well, that'll move on error. But yeah, it does have, you know, it's got some mobile here. It's up over its MAs now. That's nice. What else can we say about it? I think the reasoning is this here. So what we do is we draw a triangle trend line like this. Oh, sorry. Wow, is this my computer? Is this TradingView doing this today? I can't ever remember experiencing this with TradingView. So I think the reasoning goes something like this. Right? Oh, look. It's breaking out. Oh, the volume. Right, it's the volume. There's 200 and... No, there's $300,000 is rolled over in this. In a whole day. Time they bought it for that to happen, and the last time they bought it for that to happen, and the time before for that to happen, and we could go on and on. Doesn't mean it won't, you know, get going. Well, okay, let me put it this way. Anybody can get the stock going if they want to, and I promised I wouldn't say anything, but anybody can get that stock going. I could get that stock going right now. I could send that stock right through the, you know, anybody can. Anyway, I promised I wouldn't say anything, and I did. Tesla. Yeah, Tesla rocks. Tesla is future forward. You know, the thing about Tesla is, what if he fails? That's the only thing about Tesla. Like Google, Amazon. I mean, Amazon's putting, you know, flying distribution centers into lower orbit with, you know, futuristic drones to deliver crap all over the place. I mean, and you think Tesla, like, I don't know, like Amazon makes money. They got a model that works. I don't know, maybe Tesla will do it. Don't forget he wants to connect our brains to computers too, right? What are we going to do today? Take over the world. Come on, let's get some Momo going here. Man, I hate this about Power Hour now. I should almost just use Power R to study. Dig in and study. What else we got going? I want to put out a tweet that says, A's and S. Let's do it. Well, I gotta say it, my swings are rocking. Just went through them. What a great day. If Comey had something on Trump, wouldn't he, said it a long time ago, people? Seen that right, but I guess I should have just hit S&P with a ETF real quick for an afternoon play there. Wow, thanks for the support online, guys. Wow. Yeah, really quiet. So what do we got? Almost 3 o'clock. Apple, rocking the show. Way to go, Flash. That's one of the few I'm not in. Well, not in. I shouldn't say it like that, but of those types. Rocking. Oh, here comes the shippers. Here comes the shippers. Tops. TOPS. I hate to admit that I'm even putting this into the room, but it's actually on the move. So let's see. You know you got a problem with the chart when you got the 60 minute up and it looks like that. That's not even the daily or the weekly. It's the 60 minute chart. That's awesome. Okay, on the 30 it starts to come alive. Okay, if you're gonna go in here on this big move, 38 cents is your wall, and you're at 34. Caution, listening to the gurus. I don't see one of them talking about tops and that 38 cent wall. Not one of them. Nope. I see them all saying tops. Well, 4 cents on 34 cents isn't bad, but you gotta time that just right. Netflix, what a rock star. Dries. Here comes the shippers. Let's see where they Dries wall is. There's one particular room I like watching, and he's very popular. He has lots and lots of people in his room, and he's hardly ever in there. He shows up once in a while, and he plays mainly in low floats, and he alerts them, and then boom, they spike, and then well, the story from there, but. It works, I guess. Dries. Okay, trading 198, 199. You do have a bit of a wall here at 203 if you're in it. Or thinking about getting in it. And 224-ish. Just so you know it's there. And you got a gap fill at 219 to 225. Look at that. It coincides with your MA. So it could get there. I mean, it could go anywhere it wants. Look at what happened with Dries earlier in the year. That was crazy. That was insane. Went from, what did it go from 25 cents to $250 or something? I can't remember. So VTL didn't continue. GII sure looks like short covering in here, but it's hard to say. Got up near VWAP and backed off. Dries chart looks like VIX. Yeah. For VIX. Sorry, I'm in one of those moods today. It's nice to be in real plays, right? Like, it's nice, like on our swings, for example. I keep going back there, and I hate to sound like a broken record, but man, it is nice. Like, on a frustrating day like this, mind you, I made a little bit of money this morning, three, four, $500 or whatever it was, 550. Mean, that's okay if you can do that every day, but it doesn't build wealth. Wealth comes from letting your money work for you. And anyway, it's nice when you have the frustration of day trading sometimes. The algorithms are producing for us very well. The swings are doing very, very well. The algorithms are doing better than the swings, but the swings are doing well. I mean, if you can do 80 to 300% on your swings a year, gives you a little bit of room to screw up on your day trades. So this is pretty aggressive right here, just so you know. That gets up over VWAP, this GII. I don't know anything about them, so I can't even comment. But that's an aggressive chart on the day. That MACD. This is only 1 minute, of course, but it gives you a microscopic view of what's going on, and that's pretty aggressive. It gets up over that VWAP. I'm gonna move it over to the 3 and 5 minute. I might hit that. S&P got a little bit of life. Oil held. oiled up fine, so it's going for the target. I just don't have the oil chart up. It's doing great. I guess I should, since oil is so bullish, I should bring up the oil chart just for any of our algo subscribers. And by the way, just in case you missed it earlier, I won't be able to be sharing this chart once that room opens. Our members have been really good about it, but you know, we do have commitments. And we have an upgrade to this charting coming right away too, but that's for the room. That's the nice thing about these algorithms, you develop them one step at a time and they just get better. That is the cool part. Like conventional charting, it does kind of frustrate you, like when it breaks down and you have to start all over and you go, oh, okay, here we go. The algorithmic models, they don't break down. This might take a minute or two. There's a lot going on here. Sino. My shipper, but it's such a small position, ESEA, I'm underwater on that one, literally. In a stock sense. On scanners, give me a good one. I gotta get Sartash to code me a real good scanner here one day soon. The scanner that Sartash is gonna code first, and he doesn't even know it yet, is the one for our setup. I think he already knows we're going there anyway. I think he was the one that told me he was going there soon. That's the scanner we need, specific to our setup. Nice thing about the oil room is I won't have to load this chart. It'll just be ongoing all day. I guess with the updates. But we'll be updating it live in the room too. So after the oil room is open and it's accomplished properly, and targets met and stuff, then it's gold. Silver and other metals. Wow. There it comes. Painless. Sarcasm. Oh. No. Okay, here we go. Come on, baby, you can do it. There we go. We have lift off. That right into the target. So bullish. So, you know, I'm not telling you how to trade, but if I, and I, you know, I messed up my trade earlier on the algorithm, so consider that, but I would seriously consider at least trimming in here when you get up in there. So what time is that at? That's at 1 o'clock in the morning. So sometime. I'd be cautious because, it could drop into this target tomorrow. Like, I wouldn't be surprised. But that's trader, that's not, Because, I have screwed up my last few trades in the way that I could have got lots more. Because up here, when it was testing here, I entered the short and I left way early. And then when I entered the long on the bottom, I left early. So take that into consideration. Okay, I'm just gonna say it. So the thing that bugs me a lot about a lot of these gurus is they're always picking out the bottom plays, right? Well, anybody can pick out bottom plays and get a bounce off a bottom play because what do bottom plays do, right? Your probability of a bounce on an extension on a bottom play is huge, but what does it do after that, right? So it's just constantly like it's like whack-a-mole, like you're playing whack-a-mole all day. You don't build wealth. And I gotta stop complaining about it. But I gotta figure that out. Sorry, guys. I'll figure it out. Netflix, rockin'. Rockin'. Oops, sorry, that was an old chart. That was 20 minutes old. What's it doing now? AGD 52 week highs. Spicer won't say if Trump has confidence in Sessions. Oh yeah, AMBA. It reports after the bell. AMBA. Right. GLBS. So another bottom play. There's tops. Just about got to resistance and it backed off. Got a cent away. Remember I was saying 38. I did 200's come down now a bit, so. But yeah, 38. It hit 37. Okay, so they're taking GLBS off the bottom, so we may as well take a look at it, just in case anybody in the room is in it. I feel a moral obligation to make sure that when the, what do we call them, the Momo Pumper Crews start up on the bottom, get lift stuff that, I just remind people that there are resistance. Because it always seems like right when they start pumping them, they're getting right near the resistance. Let's take a quick look. I'll trade these, but I'll trade them smart. GLBS. Pounds. Nope, we want GLBS. I don't want to sound like I know it all because I'm actually just an above average trader. Technician, a little above average, but as a trader, I'm just an above average trader. I'm not a great trader. I'm good, but I'm not great. Technician, different story. Give me some math and I can probably figure it out. Fail. GII. Tops. Hit resistance. Dries. Yeah, see, it got through the first resistance. Now it's going after the other one. That's why when I said, when I was showing you the setup, I was like, okay. I looked at the first one and I kind of flipped past it and went to the second one and said, there's your gap fill resistance. I said, you might get there to 220. Well, at the time it was 225. Now it's 223-ish. So, GLBS. Spike. Down. Spike. Slowly down. Spike. Slowly down. Okay. Not that, you know, it someday might... It might get off the ground someday and go. So yeah. They're in here buying. Let's see what we got. We got $1.48. We got, well, there's $1.5 million rolled through here today. The big wheels are in here. Let's go to the 30 minute. Big wheels are rolling. It's up over its MAs on the 30 minute. That's not a bad setup. 200 MA. I'll be careful because it never holds its gains, but that's, you know, that's not bad. It's better. Much better. See how we're doing on the hourly here. That's better. See, that's not so bad, that one. It just doesn't hold gains, so you don't want to hold it, but... 2 hour? There it is. Oh, there it is. So we are at... on the intraday, 178. By the time price gets there, you know, you may as well call it 168 or so. That's where your resistance is going to be. So you still have some room. Yeah, you do. So, you know, call it 165 to be safe. So if you're trading it, you get another 20 cents or so. Just reading your guys' comments about silver, you know what? I completely agree with silver. So do the algorithms. The math agrees. And hey, you know, I don't want to be too hard on the shippers because you never know. I mean, anything can happen. I don't want to be too hard on the gurus either, but you know what would be nice, and I'll just, this is the last thing I'll say, you know, while, when they're online and they're like, you know, because there's like tadpoles out there, right, like there's like newbies out there, and it just, it sucks to watch, but why not tell them where that resistance is at the same time, because it's, you know, it's not selling the sizzle, I get it, don't sell the steak, sell the sizzle, Kurt. But how do you sleep? Hey, I'm not young, and I'm going to sleep forever sometime, you know, soonish, sooner than later. And I'd rather have that be, you know, decent, as decent karma as possible, whatever you want to call it. If nothing else, you know, leave something for my kids to be proud of. It's probably a better way to put it. Heritage, right? Isn't that what they call it? Heritage. So this one's working its way up. Top sauce. sorry. But you know, I gotta say, I'm doing really well because I'm not like calling them out online or anything. I'm not doing any of that. And you know, my old self would have done that. So you guys would have just laughed all day long. How do I go in all the trading rooms? Because I have a bunch of monitors and I can have a gazillion windows in each trading room, and you just go in them and watch. So that's how you do it. You can do it at home too. You just right click on your down here on your little Chrome, right click, like here, you know, these are different windows. You can have as many as you want. Watch as many rooms as you want. If you want to pay the, you know, you have to pay the fees to get in if they're chargeable. Some of them are free. Oh, I see. You're wondering how I'm going to run them. Oh, no, no. We have moderators for all of them. We have technicians for all of them. Sorry. I thought you were talking about how I spy on all the other rooms. It's not a matter of spying, actually. You know, you get a lot of great ideas from trading rooms, so that's why I watch them. And I'm like the trading room police. I think I'm like responsible for all these newbies. It's like retarded. It's like a curse. But it's not like I disrupt anybody or say anything. Yeah, so anyway, getting back on track. Our trading rooms, no, I'm going to float between them. I'm going to go visit everybody all day long. But no. So oil, like we've had, you know, 20 or 30 people inquired to be moderators. And of course, there's different types of folk that have inquired. And Sartaj knows better than I do. But there's, you know, there's some high caliber people in there that know what they're doing. And of course, you know, we have members that understand how to trade our algorithms. And so we'll have a mix of different people, just like there's a mix in this room. In this room, you know, the longer you've been around, the kind of the quieter you get or whatever, and it would help actually if some of them would wake up and get in here. And but you know, they're doing the same thing I'm doing. It's just I'm running the room. You know, they're in those swings, like our swing platform. Most of our more experienced people and people that have been around for any amount of time, they're in the oil algorithm, they're in the swing platform, and they're in the day trading platform, but or you know, one of the algorithms. But because they're doing the same thing I'm doing, right? It's nice to make money while you're sleeping or you're day trading or whatever, and it's nice to even it out. But they become very good at it too, right? Like some of them are much better than I am. Like Maven's day trading has beat my day trading to date. Like, I don't know what I am year to date. End of the quarter's coming out right away, and you know, I think the first quarter, I didn't even know what it did, 44% or something like that. You know, so on my day trading, I don't know what it'll be. You know, so far, year to date, might be I'm up 80% on the year. My swings are up fantastic. Mind you, my day trading beat my. But my point is they're both producing for me, right? And our algorithms are producing. And, so there's people like Maven, you know, last time I checked up 556% on the year when I was up 40-some percent. Or Flash in the swings, you know, just killing my swings. Different people in different rooms doing different things, and the moderators will be able to float around between the rooms too themselves and switch off. And we have people starting their own rooms. Actually, if you go to our website, we actually outlined the vision, if you can believe it, when we first started late last year, about what our full vision is for it. And so we're just kind of starting the first leg of that. So thanks for asking. Well, wish some of them would wake up. What I'm talking about there is we have, like some, it's not a secret that Flash goes, for a scotch at lunch and has scotch that's worth more than my car. But, they're doing well. There's a group of people in here that do very, very well. And there's people learning too. It all depends on what you want to do. I mean, you don't have to get involved, right? It's not like I'm saying, hey, it's a service, right? It's just like somebody changing my oil. I get my oil changed because I don't want to change the oil. People can come to the room or into our services because they don't just simply don't want to change their oil. Like when I go get my oil changed, I want to talk to the guys. I get a break. I've had people literally comment, say, "Hey, Kurt, I just turn you on and I leave you on all day while I do my work or I clean the house or whatever." And when I hear you get excited about something, I jump in. So, and they've asked me to try and communicate more, and I'm doing my best. That's my challenge in life, public speaking and talking. Like in my private life, I don't talk ever. Unless it's sartash and ideas about what we're doing, then, I don't stop. But day to day, I don't talk. Yepers, enough about me. Here we go. We're on our way. 2:24. Careful, careful. May as well call it 220. Careful, careful, careful. You get over that though, and you'll get up in. I mean, you could. I shouldn't say you will. You could get up into 250. While it dries, you could get up into new cars. GLBS 177. What else are they talking about here online? Scanners are really quiet. AMRS. AMRS. I missed that halt. Shoot. Did it restart? AMRS. Know, the one thing about watching the other trading rooms while I'm trading opens is that you do get the benefit of, one thing is ideas, but you get the benefit of when people make mistakes right in front of you live, it causes you to stop and go, I was just about to make that mistake. Learning from other people's good. AMRS. CLSN has got a pretty active tape right now. So dries is really strong here. Like, you know, for an inch a day. Not something you'd want to hold and have it make you money while you sleep, but it is strong intraday. Like, I would even be tempted. Wow, there's not much room there. I guess there's 10, you know, you could get 10% in there. So here comes its test. It's nothing to sneeze at, but you can lose 10% quick too. But anyway, you whack it for 10,000 shares and make 10%. That's not a bad few minutes. So this is a straight momentum play, and that's got some momentum. That's AMRS. CIE has got a good tape. Micro, GLYC, looks like this is going higher here. What happened to S&P? Wow, look at that, eh? Right in the target. Something happened with the whole Carney thing, or Comey, I mean. hardly got halfway to resistance. Oh boy. See, I was looking at that one target. Like the target options here. There's two, right? There's one. And I was like, why are these so far apart? There's a third possible right here. But that was so light. I didn't even put it in there. But these were the clusters here. Wouldn't that be neat if it, I mean, volatility has gotta come off, come up, if that target hits it. That's a pretty good downdraft if that happens. This is more likely, but sideways. That's a pretty big hit. I mean, you know, that fast, right? Especially because, like, oil's up too, right? It's divergent for sure. I'm not sure why. But it's there. That's the nice thing about trading price, right? You don't have to. I mean, you wonder like I am right now, but you don't have to, like. Yeah. If this happens and that happens. So when the Comey thing is a nothing, VIX is going to go back to its deathbed. It's awesome. So I was waiting to see if this diagonal line right here got lost. It stopped on a fib. Wow, it's leaving the quadrant. Look at that. So it's testing a fib now. There's another fib here, and up above that is a lot of. Come on, chart. Oh, yeah. Like it leaves there, gets up over those fibs, and it's going to go for. I got to say, I'd probably myself go long here. Because it'll go for this here. It'll go for that apex up here. Like, I know that's a leap and a half, boy. That'd have to happen tonight because this is tomorrow. This target. Wow, that's bullish. On no news too. Just a bottom bounce. Definitely didn't trade that bottom bounce well. Kurt, the base hitter. If I was a baseball player, I definitely wouldn't be a grand slammer. I just base hit. In day trading, anyway, swing trading, a little different. Here's the baseball field, by the way, right here. Our algorithm looks like a baseball field. It's just that our well, you know, anyway. But yeah, it gets up over that resistance, and this is possible up here. It'll be interesting when that P&L comes out, Sartaj, when the epic traders go through that P&L and realize the kind of return that epic. You know what would be really interesting is to see if a trader actually beats epic. Mind you, I think I'll beat epic, like when the room starts, because of the intradays, because epic is trading the channels and the wider support and resistance. Yeah, Bernard, you got the right idea there. Totally. By the way, for people in the room that are wanting to help us with the moderating and stuff, we're going to contact everybody here sometime right around, you know, right before the room opens, sometime on the weekend. Well, it's right into that. It's right into that target area, but it sure wants to get up over there. That's going to be really interesting. Super interesting. I'll be back in a minute. sorry, I just had to take a quick potty break there to be truthful. Not that you need to know that. So the S&P, it held that FIB support. Well, maybe it's just traders see what I see, and it's just a bit extended sideways. So tops, look at that, eh? Got a cent away from the resistance and off it goes. Like, see, I'm going to say it again, just last time for the day, but why not tell them that? When, like, what's wrong with saying, hey, right, I keep forgetting, sell the sizzle, not the steak. Dries here comes up to its resistance. GLBS. That's my bulldog in the background, by the way, in case you're wondering what that is. It's not me slobbering. AMRS. Okay, so we got 10 minutes left. I should have done a homework session in that last hour there, but oh well. Like, I mean a homework session right in the room. Checked all my swings and stuff. What else we got here? Oh my good lord. Oh, they're telling everybody to hold these overnight. Oh. Speaking of swings, I think I'm going to roll out of my MXIM here. It's just a little overextended. Anyway, I've got it on my other monitor. I won't even bring it up. Closing MXIM. Should have closed it earlier in the day. I had alerted that I was going to do it, and then I didn't. Wow, Bernard, you might be right. Look at the oil. That's incredible. Think that's pretty decent resistance there, those fibs it's getting into right now, and it sure looks like it's gonna. Guess we'll see what the pajama traders do tonight, but. Sure is bullish. But that's what happens when you get into another quadrant like that. Just picture them as baseball fields. So there's a full baseball field on the screen right now. just looking at all my swings, thinking if I was going to close them out, I should have closed them out yesterday or wait for the other side of this Comey thing. MXIM was definitely overbought, though, so I think I'm going to hold on the rest. But I'm definitely looking at closing out most of them before the end of the month. And re-looking at it. So I might do that this week before the end of the week. We'll see how this Comey news affects the markets. I'd hate to wait for one more kind of pop and then not get it. Well, the charts are seizing up just on time, with a minute left. That was a good day, actually. Got a little bit on a day trade, $550. The swings, fantastic. The algo trading, fantastic. And, you know, some members DMing me about their wins. We didn't get chopped up in the morning like a lot of rooms did. So that was nice. Set up really well. Those midday review videos, in my opinion, are really good. But, you know, hey, I'm one of the creators, so don't take my word for it. But we have ones we're doing for members only. They're going to be slick. They'll be better. Anyway, that's the day. So, yeah, good day. So, just so you know, the folks that are in swings with me, I know Flash has been closing out his. He's 40% out as far as I understand. I'm looking at closing mine out fairly soon. I should have started yesterday. Anyway, I'll probably hold through Comey. And we'll see yet. And yeah, as far as Tracy and Leanne, man, they're digging right in. Maven, I would follow her whenever you can. But she's an introvert herself. She doesn't get much into the room, but anyway, that was a great session, so I really appreciate it, folks. Get set up for tomorrow, and away we go. So have a good night.